do you remember Zoboomafoo? It was a PBS Kids show that ran for two seasons, from January of 1999 to June of 2001. It followed the Kratt brothers, Chris and Martin, and their lemur friend, Zoboomafoo. Each episode would start with the brothers pulling up to Animal Junction, calling over Zoboomafoo and giving him a fitting treat, followed by Zoboomafoo, or Zabu, or Zob for short, spinning around and becoming a talking puppet version of himself. Shortly after that, Zabu would describe an animal he saw on the way to Animal Junction, with the animated Who Could It Be song segment, where the brothers try to guess what animal he saw as he's describing it, and then that animal will show up. They'd have a discussion about the animal, which then would lead Zoboomafoo to remember a time in Zabu Land, the claymation flashback land of Zabu and his friends. Later, the brothers and Zabu get a letter from the animal helpers who teach kids how to help animals, which leads into the brothers going off to find other animals to fit the theme of the episode. Zoboomafoo sings the song Going to the Closet before the brothers go to the closet to get their gear to go out and get assaulted by falling loose items. The trio signs out of each episode singing the animal friend song, and then Zoboomafoo goes back to being a regular lemur and goes back to Madagascar. And then Chris and Martin go off to find more theme-appropriate animals. And that's your standard episode of Zoboomafoo. The show was created by the Kratt brothers along with Leo Eaton, and it won an Emmy in 2001 for Outstanding Directing in the Children's Series, along with Gold and Silver Parents' Choice Awards that same year. Now, I definitely had a stretch as a kid where I was really into the show, along with a stretch in high school where I couldn't stop referencing it for, like, at least a week or two. But what stuck with me the most over the years were, one, just the name Zoboomafoo, and two, the lemur himself, the actual lemur and the puppet ones, both versions, those eyes. Zabu was played by a lemur actor named Jovian, a cockerel shafak, who has a really good amount of details available about him. He lived in the Duke Lemur Center in Durham, North Carolina, where the show, as you'd imagine, was largely filmed. His father, Nigel, also played the role at times. After the show, Jovian settled down with his wife, Pia, and they had five kids named Charlemagne, or Charlie, Conrad, Wilhelmina, Adelaide, and Gisella. Charlie was actually kicked out of the family by Jovian and went to live in a different part of the center. It was a normal occurrence where a father lemur will kick out his son for competition purposes, because, you know, sometimes you just have to disown your lemur son. Sadly, Adelaide died in 2011 of a bacterial infection. He had another daughter, Gertrude, presumably born after the article on Duke's website that I'm going off of, so maybe there's even more, I'm not sure. Sadly, Jovian fell ill in late 2013, then losing a lot of weight in June of 2014, only eating in his cage before he died in November of 2014 of kidney failure in his home. The first member of his family to be born after his death was his granddaughter Isabella in January of 2015. And in February of 2019, Gertrude and her husband Remus had a daughter named Marie. And that's all the information about this star family that I could find. I didn't even talk about the puppeteer. Thank you so much for watching. Like this video if you like it. Dislike it if you dislike it. Be honest with yourself. What would Zabu do? Subscribe if you're new. Hit the notification bell to let your speeder sense tingle when I upload. Wash your hands in honor of Jovian, and I will almost definitely see you next week.